Hi, this is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to another video training on Analysis Workspace in Adobe Analytics. Today I'm going to share with you a few tips about how you can export the data from Analysis Workspace. Before we start, I just want to briefly talk about why you want to export the data from Analysis Workspace. The first use case is when you have a project which is designed as a dashboard and it has many visualizations, comments, insights, and you want to share it with your colleagues so that they will open it and see exactly how it's been made in the user interface of Analysis Workspace. In this case, you may want to export the project in a PDF format. Another use case is when you want to continue data analysis in another tool like Microsoft Excel, for example, and you don't want to use Adobe Analytics Report Builder because maybe this is just a one-time exercise for you. Maybe this is something when you want to combine the data that you have in Adobe Analytics with the data that you do not have in Adobe Analytics, like your offline data or probably some ad cost that you export from ad platforms, and now you are doing something to combine together everything in one meaningful picture. And obviously in this case you may want to export this data into a CSV file. In Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace user interface provides you both options. I hope you're already familiar with download CSV and download PDF capabilities. Today I'm going just to give you a few more tips about how you can make the export quicker and more convenient and more flexible. But first, before we start, let's add another freeform table to our project to just have a little bit more data. And now we will start with the CSV export. I'm going to download the CSV file and we will have a look how it will work. Click on the downloaded file and let's see what is inside. As you see, in my case, Microsoft Excel correctly parsed the file. The file is built the way that the data is separated by a colon character. If your operating system is configured the way that a semicolon character is used instead of comma character, then when you open the CSV file in Microsoft Excel, you may face a kind of small challenge because the data will not be separated into different columns. And you, in this case, may want to use the feature that is called text to columns to properly parse the CSV file in Excel spreadsheet. But in my case, everything works well, and now let's briefly talk about what we have in this file. So first, we have a header that represents the panel. For every panel that you have in your project, you should expect this type of header. Then for every freeform table, you will have its own header. In my case, we have two freeform tables, and this is why we have two headers for them. And under freeform table header, we have the table with the data. This is exactly why we wanted to export this to CSV file. And now we obviously can either delete the lines that we do not want to see in this spreadsheet, or we can just copy the fragments of the data into a separate spreadsheet or to continue some manipulation right in this file. But now let's consider some other scenarios. I'm going to get back to Analysis Workspace. And now let's see what we have in this project. We have only two freeform tables, but what if we have many panels, many freeform tables in each of the panel? And this may become slightly inconvenient because every time when we export the data into CSV, we will need to find out where the data, where the freeform table that we want to get some data from. What you can do instead? Instead, you can just quickly copy the data directly to Microsoft Excel. How to do that? Let's imagine that I want to export the data from the freeform table 2, and I can just right click and select copy to clipboard, and then come back to Excel and just paste everything from the clipboard. As you can see, now it's much quicker, and we were able to quickly paste only the table that we wanted to have in our Excel spreadsheet. So let's probably make it a little bit bigger so that you can better see this. Now, what if you want to copy not only the numbers but also percent? In this case, it's not possible. As you can see, what we have in this case, the visits column contains only numbers. The same thing happens when you export everything into CSV format. Now I'm going to show you what you may want to do if you also want to export the percentages that you can see under the metrics. So in this case, you would need to add another column with the same metric. You basically need to duplicate it. And for that column, just uncheck the number so that it will show only the percent. Right? So now, if I copy everything to clipboard and paste in Microsoft Excel, we will see the numbers that represent the percent. So very quickly, I can just change the format, and now we have numbers plus percents. Very quickly, very easy to do. Obviously, this would require to add something to the freeform table. Maybe sometimes it makes sense. Now, let's imagine that you may want to copy only a certain line or line items in your freeform table. You don't want to copy the full table. What you can do in this case, just select the rows or lines, and again, use either the hotkey combination, Ctrl C or Command C, depending on your operating system, and then paste this into Microsoft Excel very quickly. Now, in this case, when we copied these two line items, they were two line items in a row. But what if you want to copy the line items selectively? So we can just use the Command or Control button on the keyboard and select those line items that we need. And then again, we can quickly paste them in Microsoft Excel. Another method that you may want to use to copy the table into Excel is not the right click, but you can just double click on the table and it will be selected. So one more time, I just click on this area, double click, and everything is selected. Now I can copy and quickly paste. Another scenario is, let's imagine that we want to copy only a certain column. So how to select the column? For example, if we click on visits and we'll start moving the mouse cursor, we won't be able to select the column. What you can do instead, you can double click on the column and it will be fully selected. You can copy and paste to Microsoft Excel. Another method is, you can start selecting from the bottom to the top. So as you can see, I started from the last row and now I was able to also select the first row. So everything is selected, I copy and paste very quickly. So hope these tips will save you some time, and now you know how to quickly paste the data into Microsoft Excel without export the project in CSV. Also, by the way, sometimes you just need to select certain cells. For example, I will select this way because this very, let's say, complex combination. But again, I can very quickly copy this and paste it in Microsoft Excel. As you see, everything is working just smoothly. And this is my favorite method because usually when I do this type of export, I just need a certain line or certain cells to be copied to Microsoft Excel. And as you can see, this is much easier and much faster because you don't need to export, then parse the file, look for certain elements within that file. I hope you like it. So this is everything that I wanted to show you for export into Microsoft Excel. And now I want to show you a few tips about how you can export this to PDF. So let me first add some visualizations, because now when we want to do something with PDF, it makes sense to make it visually attractive. And I will add something. So for example, I will add a line chart. And we can see that there are many lines, but let's select just, for example, two cells that we want to visualize. And I will also slightly change how this will be represented in the project. So it's very often that in your project there may be too many different visualizations. For example, just for demonstration purposes, I will make one of the charts very small so that only part of the visualization will be shown. So, but just imagine that you have so many different plates in this panel that you do not have enough space to show them the way that you want. The tip is, when you export the project into PDF format, it will be exported exactly the way as it's shown currently on your screen. So for example, let's imagine that you want to place many different visualizations in one line, but you face the issue that not everything is shown the way you want. So there is no enough space. Well, for example, with the freeform table, it would be something like that, when you do not have enough space to read the full segment name or dimension values. And if you face this situation, what you can do? Obviously, you can just change the sequence of visualizations. For example, in this case, I would place it somewhere underneath so that I will have enough space. But let's imagine that we do not have, or we do not want to do that, because we want to have everything on one screen. And here there will be many more different visualizations in between these ones. So what you can do, you can zoom out your browser window so that all the visualizations will have enough space to be shown. Very quickly, I'm doing this. And if I'm happy with the font size, it's readable, then it will help me to build the PDF format so that everything will be very compact. So now let's do this type of export into PDF format, and we will see how it will look. And while the file is being exported, I will just return back to 100% scale, so that we will compare what we can see on the screen when we open the project and what we will see in the PDF format after this project is exported. The file is ready, and let's open it. So now you can see that we do not have the scroll bar that we had initially in the project, and the dimension values, in our case the segment names, are in a readable format, and we can see the percentages, right? So if we switch back to the project, here we can see that the scroll bar is in place and not everything in the freeform table is in the readable format. So this was a tip how you can export the project in the PDF so that you will have everything in a more readable format. This is it for this video episode. Hope you liked it. And if it was helpful, let me know in the comments. If you have any other techniques that you use for exporting the data from Analysis Workspace, share them also in the comments. Thank you and talk to you next time. Bye.